A warm good morning, to one and all, to dear Dr. Ashwini, my dear colleagues, and dear participants. Welcome back to day four of our learning different areas of research. And here we are on day four to explore one more area of research, and that is review of related literature and variables. I'm sure that all of us had three sessions which were very enriching, which were full of new insights for us. And we are again expecting to have another day of enriching experiences for all of us. And we have another eminent researcher with us today who will help us to explore the area of review of related literature and variables. So we have with us Dr. Ashwini Karvande, who is Assistant Professor, Department of Education, University of Mumbai. Dr. Ashwini has got MSc Mathematics. She is M.Ed. She has got PGDME degree, and she has done PhD also from University of Mumbai. Dr. Ashwini has got almost 22 years of teaching experience with her. Dr. Ashwini started her career as a mathematics teacher and worked in various schools for almost 5 years. Then she taught in B.Ed. colleges also, but from last 16 years, ma'am has got teaching experience for M.Ed. students in the Department of Education, University of Mumbai. In addition to teaching to the M.Ed. students, ma'am has also been teaching to MPhil students, and a pre-PhD program courses also she has been teaching to the students over there also. Ma'am is a recognized PhD and MPhil guide with the University of Mumbai. Ma'am has successfully guided 7 students for PhD degree and 6 for MPhil degree also. At present, ma'am is guiding 4 PhD students and 1 MPhil degree student also. Ma'am has successfully guided more than 65 M.Ed. students for their research projects. Ma'am has conducted minor research project which was funded by the University of Mumbai also. Ma'am has published 2 books, and one she has edited one book also named Teacher Education with New Perspectives. Ma'am has been involved in syllabus revision committees for M.Ed., M.Phil., and PGDME programs also. Ma'am right now is an IQAC NAC coordinator for Department of Education, and she is handling this post, this work, I must say, since 2018. Ma'am has attended various national, international seminars, workshops, conferences, and has presented various papers also there. Ma'am has, to her credit, lots of number of published articles, chapters in various reputed books and journals also. Ma'am has been invited as a resource person by various institutions for seminars, workshops, and conferences. There's lots of work, academic work, which ma'am has done and has contributed a lot to the field of research and education as well. Ma'am, it is completely our privilege to have you today with us, and I'm sure you are going to enlighten our research people who have a research fraternity who has assembled here on the topic review of related literature and variables. Ma'am, let me take this opportunity on behalf of Gujarat Research Society's Hansraj Jeevandas College of Education, our principal ma'am, Dr. Anita Swami, entire AGC team, and all the participants who are here, I extend a very, very warm welcome to you. And we are looking forward to have yet another day of enriching experiences with you being around. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. And now I request you to please begin with your session. Over to you, Dr. Ashwini. Yeah. Over to you.
Dr. Karuna, for this brief introduction, and I must thank to the HSC team that inviting me and giving me this opportunity to share this topic, and thank you all of you once again for giving me such a great responsibility, and I hope I will be I will complete whatever the topics that I have given as per your expectations, and with this I would like to begin my session. And thank you once again, and let me begin my session. Archana ma'am, can I share my screen?
The permission is already given, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Permission is already given.
Yes, yes. Okay, so let me start my sharing my screen, and just let me know if you can see. Can you see it?
Yes, we can see. Okay.
I'll put off my video, if you don't mind.
It's up to you, ma'am. No worries, ma'am. No worries.
Okay. Okay. So, is it okay if my video is on, or should I stop my video?
The way you feel comfortable, and your internet depends on how strong internet connectivity you have, ma'am.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
Please take care. It is completely your choice, ma'am. Please go ahead.
Okay, so let me stop my video, and I'll start working upon it. And in between, if you have any queries, or if you have, you may ask directly, because I don't know whether I can see the queries that you are.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Ashwini, ma'am.
Yes. Yes, Karuna.
We have already told them, and again, I am just before you start. Participants, the way you have been putting up your queries in the chat box, or in the WhatsApp, you can also put up in the WhatsApp group also.
Okay.
Your queries will be taken up by the team members in between also, whenever ma'am wishes, or towards the end also, the way we have been doing it. Ma'am,
fine.
Don't worry, the queries will be taken up by our team.
Okay, okay, no problem.
Okay.
Yeah. So let me begin with my the topics which are given to me. The first topic, that is a review of related literature, and so let us begin with the topic that is very important topic in the research, as far as research is concerned at any level. It's not only for PhDs or MPhil, but if you do, before you proceed for any research, it is very important component of the research, that is review of related literature. Now, review of related literature comprises of three words: review, and related, and literature. Now, in the today's session, we will be beginning with the meaning of review of related literature, its purpose, procedure for review of related literature, the sources of information, how to organize, how to synthesize, how to present in your thesis, what are the common errors that are usually happen during the when you conduct a review of related literature, and towards the end we will see what is the significant role of review of related literature. And so with this we will start with the actual work. And as I told you, there are three words that are related with the review of related literature: the review, the related, and the literature. Now, as the word review, it means nothing but the viewing again. Viewing again is, that means it is already there and you are going to see with your lens and you are going to view it again. Now, what do you mean by related literature? Now, with literature, we will come little later, but the related means that is related to your topic. Now, literature is available as much as in abundance in this world also, or it, wherever you go, the literature is available. But related, that means it is pertaining to your study. Okay, it is pertaining to your area of interest, and only you are going to view that literature. What is literature? We will see what kind of literature that we will see in the latter part, and only that literature you are going to view it again. It's not that is you are going to generate, but it's already existing and you are going to view it again. So that is the concept when review of related literature, and not entire literature which is available, but only related to the research topic in your area of interest. Now, how there are certain ways. So your review of related, what is the meaning? It is nothing but a review of related is a brief summary of previous writings of experts. Okay. It is not fully in detail, in depth or anything, but it is a brief summary which gives you an idea what is exactly available, what is exactly there in which is exactly written by the experts, written by the researchers, and how they are with their perspective, how they have put it down, how they have reported it. That is nothing but a brief summary of review of related literature. It is an integral part of research. It is a must component. It is and very much required. How it is required, that we will see. It gives evidence that the researcher is familiar with what is already known in the field of his or her study. So this review of literature helps a new researcher or helps a researcher, and it gives the evidence that what is already known and available in the field of study. So studies on related problems are useful for indicating the type of difficulties that may be encountered in the present study, as also the possible analytical shortcomings. So this review of related literature gives an insight to the new researcher, what is relevant, what is useful, things are irrelevant, which things are available, which are the most important, how we have encountered, what are the various difficulties that you might face, and what are the shortcomings, in the existing reviews, and what are the new avenue available to the upcoming researchers. So that is also a part of this. This helps to do. At times, such studies may also suggest useful and even lines of approach to the present problem. So this gives us an idea. So review of literature also helps us to understand what are the various shortcomings. It is very important to know. It is very important to understand what are the gaps between the research is already there and the research that you are going to tend to conduct. So that is very important to know where are the pitfalls, where are the shortcomings, where are the gaps. All these things helps us when you conduct the review of related literature. So what is not a purpose of related literature? First, we will understand that, and then we will understand what is the purpose of review of related literature. The purpose of review of related literature is not to present just bibliography of researchers as a contribution of research. Keep in mind, this is not just to complete the formality and fill up the one chapter which is a part of your review of conducting when you present your report or you prepare your dissertation or thesis. It's not just to complete your chapter as such. So it is not just to present the bibliography of researches, but and also should not try to conclude that proposed study is unique. Okay, you are the first one who are undertaking this research, and it's a unique and not unique thing that you are doing it, but it is an original, as thousands of researchers are engaged all over the world, and at a given time, it is totally impossible to know what area who is working. So don't be under impression that your research is a unique and the original one. Of course, you have to undertake lots of reviews before proceeding to the further review of related literature. And so this is not a purpose for conducting a review of related literature, but the purpose of review of related literature is to gain background knowledge of the research topic, to identify the concepts relating to the researcher's problem, what are the various research topics are already there, what is the background knowledge of that research topic that you are going to undertake. You are going to identify the concepts relating to the research problem. You are going to see the variables of the study. You are going to see you are going to decide the appropriate methodology of the study. See, there could be, for example, you might be conducting a research in, you might be conducting a qualitative research, you might be conducting a quantitative research, and you should know what is the appropriate methodology of the study. Sometimes you may find that while when you are reviewing the various researches, where you are undergoing or you are browsing or you are seeing various reviews related to your study, you will find that the methodology that you are intending to conduct, it may have a shortcomings. Okay, so this helps us also you to decide whether you are, whatever you are intending, suppose you might be conducting the you are intending to conduct the quantitative research, or you may maybe survey, you may be some interviews, maybe certain observations, you may find that there could be gaps, there could be problem in future while conducting such kind of survey. So when you conduct such type of reviews, it helps us to decide which appropriate methodology is you can undertake and you can choose. It helps us to select various tools of data collection. As I told you, go through the various chapters, when you go to the various journal articles, when you go through various theses or dissertations which are already available, it helps us to decide which tool is also appropriate for data collection. Okay, see, sometimes the tools are prepared for that particular study. So there cannot be a same tool you can use as it is for your research. The objectives for that already conducted research might be different. So when you decide, okay, this tool is, you may perceive that this tool is right for my research. So let me take as it is. No, it is not that you can take as it is, unless and until if you see the objectives of the research, of the researcher who have already conducted that research. So you have to also be very careful while selecting various tools of data collection. Because they might have given the definitions for that, but I mean the author of that tool might have given certain definitions for conducting choosing that tools. So you better decide whether or select which before going for proper tools for data collection, or you may modify such tools which are very much appropriate for your study. Okay, then it helps us to decide the techniques of data analysis. Okay, so this purpose of review of literature also helps us to decide what kind of techniques you will be studying. That means you would like to go for the descriptive inferential techniques, which inferential technique is appropriate for you, descriptive research technique is appropriate for you. That is all decided, that you can get a glance of that also during the review of related literature. It helps it in identifying data sources used by the others. It helps in interpreting the findings of the study, and it helps to see how others have structured their reports. Okay, so these are the various purposes of review of related literature. And finally, it helps, this is most important, I would say, you might collect the lots of abstract, you might collect the, you may go through the various theses, you may go through the various articles, you may go through the various dissertations which are available, the websites are already there. So many literature is available there, but it is not just to compile and gather it there and just fill up the chapter, as I told you earlier, but it helps to provide the comparative data on the basis of which you can evaluate and interpret the significance of one findings. Now, these reviews which you have compiled, which you have gathered, and which you have put it in your chapter, they will be used in when you are doing the discussions of findings. Okay, they will not be just to fill the chapter, but you will check how your findings are getting corroborated or which are very much close to the findings which are already done by some other researchers, and you will try to match, you will try to evaluate that. You will also try to give the evidence that you are not the only researcher who have got such findings, but such type of findings are also some other researcher have already got earlier. So this reviews that you have compiled, that you have gathered, which you will help to in your discussion chapter, that is at the end, that is at the summary chapter. So discussion of findings are when you are doing it, you will take the help of these reviews, and you will also give that evidence that already such type of findings are available in my existing the thesis or my existing report. Okay, so that is the most important purpose of review of related literature besides the other which I discussed earlier. This is also helping you to decide what are the conceptual framework and theories that are available. That is the background knowledge, as I was telling. So whenever you are starting your research topic, you should also see what are the conceptual framework, what are the backgrounds that are available for your study. So this review of literature definitely gives you an insight. And so how some guidelines are there. So first you will start your pre-study search. Okay, before finalizing your topic, you start your pre-study search. That means you identify the areas of concern and general trends. Okay, that really helps you to decide or rather narrow down your topic, because you may decide the area. It may be school education, it may be psychology of education, it may be teacher education, it may be various areas are there which you are intended to conduct your research, or maybe management of education. But when you want to narrow it down, you need to conduct study search. It helps also to do search in the early stages, and it helps to identify the possible research problems, to refine them, to explore them, some writings and research pertinent to them. So that is the next stage. And more comprehensive search helps you to identify and examine the multitude of writings and research studies that are having bearing on the problem. So these are the some guidelines how you have to proceed before going for the finalizing the research topic. Okay, so to pre-study research, search in the early stages, and more comprehensive search. The procedure is that it is always good to collect the data of last three to five years of researches. Okay, just don't go 20 years back or 25 years back unless and until it's a historical research. If it's a historical research, then definitely you can go many years back. But if it's a quantitative kind of research or experimental kind of research or qualitative researches also, you have to see the last 3 to 5 years of researches. It is advisable to review the latest articles instead of very old articles. So the same thing. The review of related literature involves locating, reading, and evaluating reports of research as well as reports of casual observation and opinion that are related to individuals' planned research work. A review of related research is much more extensive because it is aimed at obtaining detailed knowledge of topic being studied. It has to be extensive, it has to be thorough, and it cannot be just done casually. It is not as I told you, it's not just fulfilling or completing the research chapter, but it has to be very extensive and comprehensive. You have to summarize what is already done in this particular area. So when you have to narrow down your research topic, it is an important step. Thus, RRLM forms a focused and carefully structured outline of what others have done in that area. It helps us to use an idea. A researcher before and after selecting a problem go through a variety of literature, research-based literature and conceptual literature. Now, there are two things that are there in the research literature, that is, now, research literature and the conceptual literature, that is research-based critical literature and conceptual literature. The conceptual literature, that means includes all other published materials which do not fall in the category of research literature, which includes the textbook. So conceptual literature papers whose primary function is other than the presentation of research data. So whatever the theses, whatever the dissertations, the research articles, they fall under the research literature or the published material. And the conceptual literature, that is the original work, maybe textbooks, the original idea of the researcher about that one new conceptual theory, the new theories that are already postulated by the researcher. So that becomes a conceptual literature. While planning the review work, what you have to do, firstly, you have to decide what information is useful and what is not useful. So you have to, when you are narrowing the topic, you have to decide what is useful for you and what is not useful for you. Now that is again your complete focus on your research work, what you are intending to do. Sometimes you may find lots of relevant material pertaining to your area, but that might not be useful. So you just discard it. Don't include your research chapter in the review of literature chapter, and just focus on what you want to do. They determine how to record what is gathered. Okay, but what are the various variables of the study? What are the various the tools that are used? What are the, who is the sample? Who are the what are the findings of the study? That you have to determine, and you have to record as you gather it. Because later on, when you decide to gather, and you may not recall it also, it may so happen because it may so happen that when you are actually browsing, actually exploring lots of free of literature. Determine how to record what is gathered, and setting up an orderly note-taking system. So immediately you try to set up your note-taking system. That is, various reports are there, various government-related reports are there, various handbooks are there, manuals are there. Then there are certain abstracts are there. So you have to decide, you have to set up the orderly note-taking system from the beginning itself. And also immediately note down the references from your taking. Because again, it becomes a task in the later state ki kahan se maine wo, which was the website, where from where I had gathered, from where I have gathered, got this abstract, I don't know, I can't recall. All those things should not happen in the later stage, because so you have to plan the review work according to these steps, that is deciding what information is useful and what is not useful, determine how to record what is gathered, and setting up an orderly note-taking system. So important elements to be noted, that reports problems already investigated, that you take into care, that you keep with you, and that you have to go through if it is a maybe policy research, maybe evaluative research, maybe pertaining to the qualitative researches, or maybe reports related to some government related data. If you are just evaluating various policies of education in India, and then you have to be dependent on these reports problems which are already done. And also when you are conducting certain surveys or certain in particular area, see that what are the various reports available and report which are already investigated, and what are the design of these such studies, which variables are there, what is the population, what is the sample, which tools or instruments are used, what are the hypotheses formulated, what is the procedure of conducting that entire research, what are the, how the analysis has been done, and how the findings are whether they are useful, whether they are really to be investigated again, whether they have certain it may happen that you may are doubtful, you may doubt about that findings or those in certain cases. So all these things you have to note it down. You have to also see the what are the pitfalls and what are the recommendations given in that particular study. What are the pitfalls? What are the various shortcomings? What are the various gaps in that particular research? Where more scope is there for undertaking the research if this is a particular report? If you read a complete research article or journal article, or where the research paper is published, you see to that where what are the various recommendations, and what scope is there in that such type of research, and probably that may also give you some insight, and you may be interested to go more in depth of that particular study. In the social sciences, the research, there is a wide scope as compared to the pure sciences probably, whatever all the researchers or all the investigations are all because the new researchers have identified that there are certain gaps, there is a certain scope in that, where some mathematic problems are there, some mathematic theorems are there, and certain axioms are already, or some assumptions are already done. So you may challenge to that assumptions also. So these are the things where the researcher might be interested to know, and he says that the researcher may challenge to that assumption and then further conduct the study. So all these things are very much interesting and important elements to be noted, and if you want to start your further research, look into that particular reports. Okay.
Ashwini ma'am, yes? Sorry to interrupt you, yes, but there are a couple of questions. Would you like to take those questions related to whatever you've done till now, or you would like to take all the questions at the end?
No problem. Okay, I'll just go through this.
Shall I pose the questions for you?
I have just opened the chat box. So.
All right.
Okay.
All right.
What if the study is not available in 2 to 5 years? Of course, you can go back to more than if it is not there. Now, for example, online teaching, now all of us are going through this major issues like online teaching and attitude of parents towards online teaching. So definitely in India, we do not have such old researches. I'm sure about that. So it's a current thing. But if you want to see if it's not, the material is not available, then it may be fresh research also, or you may look back into the more older researches or the material available to you. You may will only online review of related research? No, it's not enough. It you have to have extensive and thorough researches. You are supposed to visit the libraries. You are supposed to visit the libraries where all the old theses, which are not in the digital, are not available. And if you are conducting historical research, I am sure online reviews are not available. So it's not only online review is possible. You have to go physically and find out that your research is conducted in that particular area. If it's a specific topic, then definitely sometimes online reviews are not available. As far as the Indian research, I'm sure now we have Shodha Ganga and all those things available. But earlier it was not, so the students used to visit in the department libraries, or maybe the in Mumbai University, they used to go to the main library, Jawaharlal Nehru Library. All things used to be there. So it's not necessary only online. Could you suggest share method of note taking or an example? Yeah, we will share as we proceed. If there are only 2 or 3 research studies, then no problem. If there are only 2, as I told you, online, for example, our students did not find attitude towards online teaching for the Indian parents. So no problem. It's not available, then no, don't include it. Just mention, sometimes Indian, when you are conducting Indian reviews, it's quite chance possible that the Indian reviews, you may not find many in number. So that's okay. Then restrict to that only.
Ma'am, can I ask you one question, ma'am? Sorry.
Just a minute. Let me go through this chat box and then I will. Yeah, you may not get the, so you have to rely on online research. Yes. Few websites, I'll come to that websites. Yes, I will come to that. What if only abroad studies are available in audience? Yes, no problem. If it's not there, you can justify if it's not available. There is no harm, whatever, because you may not find, that doesn't mean it's not conducted in India. As far as the tendency of Indian researcher is concerned, they are firstly not so much keen to publish their research work. If it is there, the resources, they are not coming across with the resources, how to upload and all those things are there. So lots of things are there. So that doesn't mean that such type of study is not conducted. If it's not available online, you may probably go and visit to certain areas or certain libraries where chances are there that the books might be available, the conceptual literature might be available, written by the Indian people or written by the some eminent persons also. Yes, sir. You may ask question. Yes, Vinita ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, मला विचारायचं होतं, जे आपण review related literature आपण जेव्हा thesis मध्ये लिहितो, आपण जेव्हा start करतो writing, तर त्याच्यामध्ये approximately Indian आणि foreign abroad से approximately किती असणं गरजेचं आहे रायटिंग
करंट आय मीन एज फार एज द गाईडलाईन्स आर कन्सर्न फॉर द PhD वी एनकरेज आवर स्टुडंट्स टू इन्क्लूड ऍटलीस्ट मोर दॅन 50 to 75. Okay. So Indian, because there are variables, it depends actually. See, at the PhD level, there are many variables. Many
yes, ma'am.
So in that Indian and abroad karke aaram se 75 tak ho jata hai. So there is no limit as such, but most relevant and most latest, we encourage students, we ask our students to include in their thesis work.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I recently did a paper on design thinking, but I couldn't find any review related literature on Indian studies.
Online, yeah. In that, as I told you, the chances are very less that you may should just mention that you have to justify why.
How do we justify that, ma'am? What are we expected to write in that then? What are we supposed to write in that chapter?
Indian reviews, if not available, just that, then don't include only. But within 2-3 years, you may the chances, you keep on searching it. Okay, you may not find immediately certain things, but you may get certain resources. You may in that also, if one article is also there, you may go to its bibliography. You may check who else have done in that particular, maybe only one research article is there. So you see what the references that person has gathered, from where he has gathered and prepared his paper, and you may see his references or that researcher's references. You may search in that also, because okay, so it is you. There are various ways to go into in depth, and you can check the.
Yes, ma'am. But ma'am, in case if it is not available, what are we expected? We just leave blank over there. We do not write studies conducted in India and we leave it blank.
You just mentioned as far as you have to be very diplomatically mentioned that as far as the researcher's knowledge, the researcher could not find any reviews related to this particular area. So that is that diplomatic sentence that you will not say that there is no research on you. It's in your capacity, you couldn't find it. So that's fine. Okay. So you may mention that just one line, and you may mention that researcher could not get any research. And that is why your research is the unique. Don't claim like that. Don't make any such bold and claiming statements ki main first researcher karke. Okay. You may not know, because the experts who are there, who are evaluating your researches, they may say that how can you make such bold statements. So don't make such bold statements, and don't claim that you are the first researcher in this particular field. Okay, you are not getting that, doesn't mean Indian research nahi mila. That's okay, nahi mila to it's fine. It's fine. Absolutely no, don't worry, don't bother about that. Okay, like my students, now we are conducting online research. Many of our students now, because of this COVID, all of us are doing online researches. So the students were interested to know what is the attitude of their parents. What is also, they are interested to know what is the well-being of teachers. They are conducting online classes. How, whether they are stressed or whether they are not stressed. So in Indian, they did not find so many Indian reviews as such, one or two, that's okay. Sometimes that one of my students didn't find any Indian parents' attitude towards online teaching. She did not find till date. So that's okay. Nahi mila to we can't bang our head and okay, somehow you can produce it. Don't do that. That also. We will see what are the various errors that we researchers commit while doing the review of literature. So I think I should continue with whatever the topics that is given to me. Shall I, Archana, shall I proceed?
Yes, ma'am, you may proceed.
So during the process of review of related researchers, the researcher should keep the following few questions in focus. What are the key sources? Okay, there are sources, you will see that also. There are primary sources, there are secondary sources, there are tertiary sources. So what are the various key resources that are there? The major issues and debates about the topic. Okay, there are certain reviews, there are certain articles which are debatable, which are full of issues. There are what are the origins and definitions of the topic. Okay, so there are certain conceptual definitions and there are certain operational definitions. Whenever we have a variables, we will see parts of the study in the later part. There are variables and there are certain. For example, there are leadership theories. So what are the original theories? Okay, and what is the leadership for my particular strategy? That becomes your operational definition. The researcher, the theories on leadership, there are trait theories, there are traditional theories, there are contingency theories, there are lots of designs for the leadership, there are so which theory is you are using it for your research work. You may have the extensive research on the theories of leadership and you may design you can create your theoretical background for your research work. But and what are the originals, and you may pick up certain definitions of leadership. So that's fine. That is okay. That is so you have to choose and which is in for your particular research or which theory you are interested, you can go with the in-depth work for that particular leadership theory. And then you may give the design, the leadership definition of that leadership work, theory or the definition of leadership by that particular theory. And then you can modify it and operational definition for the leadership for your work based on that particular theory. Okay, and then you can go design your tool, prepare your dissertation, tool for the data collection. And then you can add the questions related to that particular theory and which are more suitable for your samples or your population. What are the key theories that already and key ideas about the topic? And what are the main questions and problems that have been addressed today? Okay, so research questions, you ask the questions, the research questions pertaining to those theories. There may be doubts while collecting while reading that particular theory. You may have certain samples in your mind, maybe the teachers, maybe the students, maybe the students, primary students, maybe the higher education students, whichever the students in your, some ideas you might get. So go on asking the questions, which might be the research questions, and then you can proceed for your further review of related research. See, ultimately you have to narrow down your research work, review work, because the literature may be ample literature is there. For example, if you go with the leadership theories I'm talking, there are very, you may find the leadership in the various kinds of managements are there. It may be in the corporate sector, it may be in the companies there, it may be in the political area, it may be in the education sector. So where you are intending to focus, you want to study leadership from the political perspective, you want to study the leadership from the management or the private sector perspective in the government sector, where you want to study, or in the education sector, or only you are restricting to the principals or only to the classroom managers who are the leaders also. You have to narrow it down the leadership in various ways. So that are the main questions may arise while studying the various questions and problems. So sources of information. So as I told you, the literature, as a review of related literature. So what kind of various literature, that is nothing but the sources of information. So there could be preliminary sources, indexes, abstract to the locate books and articles. Now this is, you may drop this idea because nobody nowadays goes in the libraries and check the index numbers and abstracts and look at the books and all those things, articles. Most of the things nowadays happening online. So these are the earlier days or when there is no facility of web browsing, webs and all, the preliminary sources was the indexes and abstracts to look at the books and articles. The primary resources were the publication in which persons who carry out the research report findings. It could be journal, it could be books and original work which is done by the researchers. So this is the primary resource. These are the researches. These are the sources, those type of information that comes first. See, there might be the textbooks, there might be the conceptual textbooks, there might be the literature written by that particular author, which is his own ideas, his own written work. So that is the primary resource. That could be primary resource also, as well as it could be a publication in which the person is could be report also. The secondary sources will be the publications in which author is reporting on research that someone else is carried out, that is books and textbooks. Okay, so the he is writing, for example, about the war. A person might be looking from his perspective about the war, and he might be the sufferer, he might be the the viewer, or might be the psychologist, maybe the sociologist, and he is looking to that war in his own way. Or as I maybe some teacher education, if it is there, then the teacher, suppose some policies on teacher education is there, one is policy report is already available and then views by the various people on that particular policy, and he is writing the conceptual article based on that particular policy. So that can become the secondary resource. But the tertiary resources are further removed from the original material and are rare distillation and collection of primary and secondary resources. So maybe your thesis, you are gathering lots of work, lots of researches in and including in your dissertation. So that, and somebody is referring your dissertation. So that can become the tertiary resource. Now this some person who got the news researcher who is referring your dissertation work, he have not actually referred and seen the original books. He has not actually seen the reports which are already available, original. Or he might not have seen the dissertation, research articles also or journals. He has not referred it, but he is referring your work, which is then it becomes a tertiary resource. Anybody has doubt in this, you may ask directly also, because there might be lots of confusion. As far as the sources of information is
concerned. Hello, ma'am, may I?
Yes.
Ma'am, I'm doing research, PhD. So I did some research paper on related to my PhD topic. So when I will, can I put that particular research paper as a review of literature as a
yes. Sorry. So here's the list of some resources. See, anything, any material, let us see what can be the literature or sources of information. You may refer to encyclopedias, subject catalogs of libraries, documentation service, bibliographies, list of books, publishers, bulletins, periodicals, everything related to your... So anything, e-journal, the original research article, the journals, the government reports, the research abstract, the dissertations, thesis, conference proceedings also. It might be also, you might have seen some PowerPoint presentation, and that can be your resource, source of information. Okay, where you may find some unique diagram, which you might have not seen somewhere else. So that can be, but everything you have to report in your work. Otherwise, it goes as a plagiarism. Okay, whatever you are including, it could be newspaper article, it could be magazines, online materials, audio tape, any number of sources of information. It can't be the only source of information, and everything related to your topic becomes a source of information or a literature.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
All the references cited in books and articles, as I told you, I am referring someone else's dissertation. Okay, so I may check the references done by that researcher. So that's okay. You may include it only you in your research also, but you just mention that you are cited in this dissertation. That's all. That is fine. So whatever material pertaining to, see, while doing research also, you may find in the newspaper the article which is very much, which might give you some different perspective. So you may include it and you may use that article in your discussion findings, which has given, you may mention that this particular article really changed my focus of looking towards that particular policy. That's all. Maybe now we have the National Education Policy, which might be a huge change after 36 years. We are 34 years, we are going to change the entire policy of education, Indian education. So which is going to give you an entire scenario. So there are certain criticisms on that policy also. So you may read both the sides of that particular coin. You may see the some people have written favorable towards that policy. Some may have criticized on that policy. So maybe you feel like you may have the third angle to look towards that policy. You may look in a different perspective. So that's all. That is, everything is Everything is fine as much as a particular source of information is there. You may include in your literature, no doubt, no issue at all. Okay, so these are the ways the sources of information can everything. So I think anything is missed out, you may say that, okay, madam, you have not included this particular thing. So all these things are the sources of information. I don't think so. More other resources are also there. We will see to that. But I think it is because of websites. Now we have the wider scope to see the review of related literature.
So, ma'am, when we write these videos, so you explain that videos in your own words?
No, you don't explain these videos. You just mention that. See, you may, from that video, you view that video, see that video, and draw certain inferences based on that video, and just mention that you have, this is your source of information, where you have cited that video. Now, this is again your own perspective. You may find that video and that video person has also given some purpose of that preparing that video. So you may include as it is and just mention that, okay, you have seen that video and this is the in APS style, American Psychological Association has given certain style of including the research references. You mention that electronic source, okay, and give the, its a reference. You have to give the reference. That is the most important thing. Otherwise, again, it is, as I told you, it is a plagiarism.
So we are definitely going to write the inference, like what did we draw from that video. So, but when you write it down, you put the URL, right? And the title of the video.
Yes. So I'll tell you how to write that abstract source. Okay. What is expected to write, how you will present your material. Okay. We will come to that also. Okay. So anything else besides this, if you feel like including, that could be the source of information. So sky is limit. There is no restriction ki only books se hi lena hai, library mein jaake baithke hi karna hai, dissertation hi refer karna hai. No, everything you feel that, okay, I may get my reference in this particular office also. I may go and approach to that office concerned for people and I may get the authentic information. If you want more authentic information, if you do not want to rely on that particular information, you actually approach to that office and get the authentic information. So now, for example, if you are collecting the data related to economics and economics of education, the government aids, government grants, everything you want to know and you want to see the actual information spent on that, the finances or the money spent on that particular policy, money or the schemes that are there. If you want to approach to get the authentic information, you can go and approach to that office also. And the authorities also with proper the letters and everything. So no doubt you can take the interview and note it down. Oh, this is the information that I've got. So that is fine. Even interviews, your observation, interviews to that particular author, that could be, you can include that in your source of, as a source of information. This here, as I mentioned, audio tapes, video tapes. Yes, it can be, especially when you go for the qualitative researches and gather the data, you might not be having the lots of information in your research topic. It's okay. For example, in the qualitative research, you go for some ethnographic researches and all. You may not have that because qualitative researches are unique. Okay, they are only for your personal area of interest. So you may not find lots of information related to the qualitative research of your research topic. That's all. If you are getting only one review, also doesn't matter. Or you may include all these videos or all the a particular maybe communities there and you are doing it for the for personal problem area of interest, then that's all. It's okay. You can justify that this is the qualitative research and I did not find, and in fact you should not find many researches in the quality. When you're going for a pure qualitative research, you may not get lots of quantity of the research, review of literature, PhD level, or I told you 75 is the number. Then if you are not getting, then good that you are not getting. You may get only one or two, that's all. It's justifiable. No issue at all. Okay? So, agar PhD research hai, or qualitative research hai, mixed method research hai, or nahi mil raha hai, toh chhod do. Nahi mil raha hai, toh good that you are not getting it. You got my point, I hope. So I may proceed. So these are the sources of information. Other than there are useful resources like Education Index, it provides up to date listing of articles published in hundreds of educational journals, books, fields. Scopus Index articles are there. Nowadays, we are very much relied on the Scopus Index articles, cited materials, the psychological abstracts. The ERIC is the website where it is by US Office Education, where you will get lots of sources of education, current index to journals, and all those things are there. Then in Shodh Ganga is there, where Reservoir of Indian Theses are there. All the universities are tying up with Shodh Ganga and they are uploading their theses, stats, the researches, the article, mostly the thesis only. The Shodh Ganga will find all the, most, not all, many reviews based on this in the Indian context. You will find this Shodh Ganga is a very good website. It is a center provides platform for research students to deposit their PhD thesis and make it available to the entire scholarly community. You can upload your thesis as the entire thesis you can upload with the, of course, now with the proper channel is there and some certain procedure are there. That means I have published my research, maybe PhD research, or my students have published my PhD research. So I will approach to my library people and they will upload that because they have the what is the authority or they are authorized to do all those things, the material, because some numbers are there, some indexes are there, which is not our area of expertise. These library people do they do that, and so we have to just give that these are our researches, and we at least I am means we university people do that. So these are my students who have conducted the PhDs and they are awarded or rewarded with PhD. Kindly upload this PhD thesis. So they do that, all those things, because they have that tie-up with the Shodh Ganga and all those things. So the repository has the ability to capture, index, store, disseminate, and preserve the all the information submitted by the that is educational journals and submitted by the research. The citation index is other resources which covers the literature of science, medicine, agriculture, technology, and social science. The citation index that covers literature of social behavior and related sciences. The mental measurement yearbooks are there. Then abstracts and indexing content related to education are there. So you can access to all of them. Nowadays, websites are available. You can do, you can go to the Google Scholar. I don't know how many of you have tried it. I will here there are the World Wide Web, the tertiary, these are all primary, secondary, and tertiary resources where I have given the list of all these. The World Wide Web can be excellent place to satisfy some initial research needs. It is a good source of background information for finding keywords for searching in the library catalog. A Google Scholar is a useful discovery tool for citations. You can try out this also. I don't know whether I can get it very quickly because so many things are there. So that's the bandwidth is again slows down. I don't know, just a minute. Can you see my screen?
Yes, we can see your screen.
But I'm just trying to get Google Scholar.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, may I ask you one question, please?
Sorry?
Ma'am, actually, I have written a question in the chat box.
Okay.
Can you answer me?
So just give me time for accessing this Google Scholar.
Okay, ma'am.
it may it has become slow. Okay, so you can go with Google Scholar and it helps you to get the citations. It is also helping you to give the, it also gives certain tips to, and it literally narrows down your topic. For example, if it's online teaching, then I will, with online teaching, it is CEO. So I will get all the researches related to online teaching. So you have to just give the keywords, okay? And you will get all the related material. Okay, I hope you can. This is just an some maybe So this is suppose my area of interest, professional commitment. So, professional, suppose this is my area of interest, professional commitment of teachers. So going Google Scholar, basically. See, you can see a PDF is there and the citation index and everything you can get. The more you browse, the more you will get an insight. Okay, and anytime, see, they are given also. You can sort by relevance, sort by date. All these things are there. Now, this is the article from Jester. ResearchGate, nowadays ResearchGate is also a very good website which helps us to get the lots of researches. Okay. So this is this, accessing website is absolutely, it is all allowed and we all there. Rather dependent on this type of research. But if you go with Google Scholar, it will solve your maximum problem. Otherwise, in the normal Google, it will give you and you have to out of that because out of that, you have to again save it down and again you have to go the advanced search mein jaake bahut kuch karna padta hai. So this is the Google Scholar is, I think it's a good option. Yeah, now let me come back to my presentation. Who has okay? there is number is not fixed. It again the research topic. What research topic that you have chosen, it the number matters on that. There is no hard and fast rule ki itne hi honi chahiye. There is absolutely no hard and fast rule ki itne sare reviews karne. Jaise lekin latest hi karne as far as possible. If you are going with the quantitative research, the latest. Who is interested to know? Will you suggest libraries in Mumbai where we can find journal, magazines and theses? So all the libraries, now Mumbai University has the Knowledge Resource Center. You can access over there and from there, they will definitely guide you how to access the journals, magazines and theses. In university also, there are lots of theses and dissertations made available. And journals are there, magazines are there. The old theses are also there. I think and even I don't know in SNDT also, SNDT University, all the universities as far as the education is concerned, all the libraries who are running the who are having the educational, sorry, what is the, they are running MEd course, BEd course or MA education courses. I think libraries with those colleges must be updated and you can access it. Some sites, yes, ask to pay for how to deal with it. No, I have not actually tried with this. What is slideshow more, please? I don't know. More, please. Yeah, I do that. I have not yet begin with my presentation. Okay. So let me come back to my... So Google Scholar is a good option. Eric, you can go and access the lots of abstracts, research articles. Some of them are full PDF articles. ResearchGate, if you go, you can access easily the full PDF articles. If you go to the Google Scholar, they will definitely help you. Now, there are certain e-journals which are prescribed by your college or your university. You can access these e-journals. You do not have to pay for that. And they are made available for the people who are in the who are a part of that organization. So we if your university has prescribed certain e-journals, they are free of cost. You can make you can definitely access them. Like Mumbai University has e-journals of Jester and one of them is Jester, one is for Springer. All you can, these are prescribed by university and we are now waiting for the renewal, but because of COVID, again, it has been delayed. But these journals are made available for all university teachers and they can access it free of cost if they are on the campus. And so other resources are there. Now, how to synthesize? Okay, you may collect lots of review of related literature. And now you have to organize them. So you have to synthesize your review of literature using a synthesis matrix. And this is a website where there is such type of Excel format is there. Your main idea and you can go on adding the sources, source one, source two, source three, source four. And at the end, you may have this proper segregation because there you might be having lots of ideas, okay? But if you go on adding in the word, it is one after the other, you may not be having that way of, again, segregation. So
could you share this link in the chat? It would be easier for us to see.
I'm just trying to, this is just a screenshot of that particular website. And I will say, yes, I will share that
link. But copy the link in the chat, it would help.
Yeah, I'll do that. So shall I come out from this and directly, you would like to access on your own?
And we could at least see.
Yeah,
otherwise... Can you show it again, ma'am? One?
Just, now, I don't know, my laptop is little slow at times, but as you have suggested, I'll share the link.
Ma'am, this is the references you are talking about. We can make review of literature.
Now this is, you may have a references now. You have gathered a sufficient material for your work now, or you might be in the process of gathering your material. Just a minute, and let me copy this link and share in the chat. Or you just type synthesis of RRL, you will get this using synthesis map. Archana, I don't know.
Polina?
Yes, Ashwini.
Acha, okay, you have done?
Yeah, I have just put it on the, yeah. This somebody's put the link, yeah.
okay, same here.
Yes, yeah, same.
So you can go on synthesizing your volume material. Yeah. Now can you see me? Can you see my screen? Okay, so this is the way you can go on synthesize. This is the main idea, and this matrix, so this type of exercise will definitely help you to narrow it down, and you may highlight your keywords, you may highlight your the variables in that study, you may highlight the findings of the study. So many options are again made available, and likewise you can access. So likewise you can segregate your material in a proper way, because you may have n number of these and फिर हो जाता है अभी मैं क्या करूँ उसके साथ कैसे organize करूँ कैसे arrange करूँ. तो such type of links are there, such type of matrix are there in the Excel sheet, or you may prepare on your own, and this will definitely help you to access your work or manage your work. Now how to present the literature. So the literature should be presented in such a way that as to justify carrying out the study by showing what is known and what remains to be investigated in the topic concerned. So for this, first and foremost thing, where the study has been conducted, where the studies have been conducted. See, the studies might be conducted in abroad, in India, in particular area. So geographical area wise, where the studies are being conducted. So when you write your abstract, when you prepare your when you want to present your literature in abstract form, you will mention that a particular study, such type of things have been are there, and this particular author has conducted this study in this particular area, in particular university, for the particular so that is the geographical wise you can give when it was conducted. That means you will mention its year, when the studies were conducted, which sample, primary, secondary, or higher secondary, that will also you will decide, mention in your review. Then what that review is covering, what that review is focusing on. So what methodology that the researchers has adopted. So you will mention that also. And most important thing, how it has been conducted. So how the data was analyzed. And also one more thing, that is what are the findings of that study? Why this findings of the study is very important, because it should match with your findings of study. It may happen that findings of the study are matching with your findings of the study. So this study, where, when, which, and what, how, and how it has been conducted, would help you to check your findings with this particular findings. You have to include them in the discussions of your study when you are writing your discussion of the findings. This, as I told you, review of related literature chapter is not just to fill the thesis, but it is important how the findings of the study are relevant with your findings of the study, or they are corroborating with your research findings. Okay, how the study was analyzed. So when you are presenting your literature, you will mention all these things. Okay, so presenting the literature is of very much importance when you include in your research. And which also helps you to identify the research gaps. And that research gaps is actually becomes the spur for your further research. That becomes the torch for your further research. So based on these, investigators should arrive at what has been done so far, how, where, when, and what needs to be done further. So that helps to identify the research gaps, and which ultimately help in building a strong rationale for the present study. Okay, so when you include the research question, rationale of the study, the theoretical framework, the conceptual framework, all these things are in the chapter one. This is the basis. The reviewing it becomes the basis for identifying your research gaps, and ultimately it helps to give you the rationale for your further research. Okay, so identifying the research gaps. So all this review of related literature is the main concern is for including in this in your research is it helps. To give you the identifying the research gaps, okay, and then ultimately how you present. Now this is again optional. For a few of my students have tried to compile it in this way, the summary of your presentation, summary of research. Nobody's going, probably the you may also may not get the time to review or read all the reviews. So you may summarize most of the researches that it represents the outline of review of literature on learning strategies. So this was our variable in India and abroad. So variables are like goal orientation language. So how that student has tried to cover the goal learning strategies with how they are associated with other variables also. Which tools and techniques are used in these various researches? What are the data analysis have been done while compiling all these things? Most of the school samples were the school students, higher education, students from higher education and teachers were there, in-service teachers were there. The methodology mostly was used as descriptive research, then multiple analysis, experimental research, and then the findings are again clubbed and they are again narrowed it down. So this is the way you can, this is for particular variable that student has done, and the students was doing the research on English language, the West was her area of interest. Then these were the other research reviews, that is, variables, the critical thinking, sale, goal, orientation, learning strategy. So again, this researcher has summarized her work in this way. So all these five things, what that she has found out. So these are the most of the methodologies, data analysis, and the tools and the samples that were there. So in this way also you can summarize. It's not mandatory how you will present your research work or summarize your research work, but students have some novel ideas, they present it diagrammatically and they again give a large picture in a brief manner, and this also helps us to get the outline of that entire research work, reviews of related literature that student has done. So this is one of the ideas that a student can do. So this is the way of presenting your research. Anna, what are the common errors in review of related literature that, these are the things that can happen.
Ashwini ma'am.
Yes.
Aapko agar break jabhi bhi lena hoga na, to just let us know. All right?
With a couple of slides, I'll give you 5 minutes break. So finishing my presentation related to review of related literature.
All right, ma'am. Completely up to you.
Yeah. Because now again I have to move for variables, so it will take another.
Sure, ma'am. Sure.
So most of the things that happen in the review of related literature, that review is done in hurriedly. जब उठो तब सवेरा वो क्या बोलते हैं वो जब जागो तब सवेरा हो जाते थे ऐसे वो स्टूडेंट्स क्या करते हैं फटाफट जल्दी जल्दी में बहुत सारा रिव्यू इकट्ठा कर देते हैं एंड एज अ रिजल्ट इट इज नॉट कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव. ये चीजें हो सकती है. दे रिलाय टू हैवीली ऑन सेकेंडरी रिसोर्सेज लाइक सेकेंडरी एंड टर्शियरी रिसोर्सेज लाइक नाउ डेज यू आर रिफरिंग समवन एल्सेस थीसिस एंड डिसर्टेशन एंड देन यू मे इंप्रूव. यू हार्डली researchers hardly see the primary and secondary resources. So that should, preliminary resources. So one should not too much, you are heavily relied on the secondary resources. You include the abstracts of the research articles, you include the, so usse aur mein kiya hua bhi, ab jyada us pe rely ho jata hai, usme bhi problem ho sakti hai. Because every publisher, every author has its own perspective or own research or research articles, and they write their own ideas and you include them in your research, in your review chapter. That's so too much, ye bhi ho jata hai ki bahut sara importance us pe diya jata hai. Concentration is on research findings only, and other important details on variables, methods are overlooked. All uniformity in review or reporting review, there no. Sometimes it may happen that no uniformity is in reporting review. All authors' reviews are not included in the bibliography. Secondary source references are not noted properly, and so these are the common errors that may take in the review of related literature. And lastly, I would like to say about the stuck some. So remember, before presenting the review of related literature, does RRL answer the following? How adequately has the literature been surveyed? Does it present pertinent material or is it just a filler? Were primary or secondary resources used? Does the review critically evaluate previous findings or is it is only a summary of what is known without pointing out any possible deficiency? If this happens, most of the time students review just go on. Sometimes only abstracts, halfway abstracts are included. They are just, some abstracts I have seen that students do not report what are the, write down that, what are the findings of the study? Is it relevant to your research work? Since it's just an abstract, one variable is seen and they just put it. Sometimes their abstracts are also uploaded on the website in a very key, in a very tricky way. They just mention halfway. The findings are not included in that abstract. Sometimes they do not give the complete picture of that, whatever is covered in that particular paper. Such abstracts, if you include, then that is not good thing. You have to, it's, it should not be a filler, it should be a very comprehensive, even if it's a review of literature. Does the review support, does the review support the need of for studying the problem? Does the review establish any theoretical framework for the study? So remember before presenting all these things. And so thus review of related literature plays a significant role in the process of research. It provides advanced knowledge that has already there in the field of study. It enables the researcher to define frontiers of this field. It provides understanding of theory in the field, which further enables researcher to place his questions in proper perspective. It helps in studying procedures and instruments that have provided useful or seem to be less promising. It ensures unnecessary duplication, and it also helps in seeking new approaches. And it provides comprehensive data, which is useful in the discussion of findings. So thus it finishes with a review of related literature. And you may take a break, and this is just a diagram which I have found in one in this website. And this is also giving the guidelines for writing a literature review. So this is also one comprehensive picture. You may ask a question if you have. And with this, I will give you 5 to 10 minutes break. And then I will proceed to the variables of the study. So these are the references. And see, I have included, now this is the reference which I have included, but this is not in the proper way, like APS style, because in our rate also. So let us start with a very important topic from the research perspective, the variable. Okay. So in this session, we will be seeing meaning of variable, classification of variable, and types of variable. Now, we will be going to answer for this particular question, what affects the plant growth? You can just go on answering or chat box mein dalo to bhi chalega. What affects the plant growth? Sunlight, okay.
When soil.
Soil, yes. Sunlight.
Water.
Yes. Soil, water, sunlight, okay. Space, very good. Environment. Environment is a fertilizer.
Climate, weather. Nutrients.
Yes, seeds, okay. Quality of seed, good harvest.
Weather, climate,
environment, okay, fine. Okay, so most of you have covered whatever is required, regular nurturing, proper care, great, good. So absolutely right that these things affects the plant growth, that is sunlight, air, okay, water, fertilizer, soil, somebody said space, so definitely space is very important for the plant's growth. Suppose if I decide to have a mango tree in a pot, it won't get that much space to grow and it will affect on its growth, correct? So all of us, we know that these are the factors which are very important for the plant to grow. So if plants grow with proper care, what is the outcome? Why do we do all these things? If it is proper, then what is the outcome?
We get the desired fruits.
Okay, it gives the desired fruits, okay. What is the outcome?
The plant will be like, the growth of the plant will be in the best way.
Best way, right? It will develop its, it may be in good enough.
That is the maximum, correct.
Okay, it may have a number of leaves will be very fresh and maybe in more quantity. Okay, what else? It may have the good quality of fruits, right? Flowers, if it's a flowery plant, then flowers. Good quality of fruits, if it's a fruit plant. So all these things are definitely there. So plant grow is, if it grows with proper care, all these things that were maybe leaves, flowers, fruits, height, everything will be in a proper way. It will cover its milestones and it will, everything will be so in a good way. Okay. So all these things, even it is applicable for the human being also, but let us, my next question is, all of a sudden what happens? So tell me who was depending on whom and who was not depending on anyone. In the plant, growth of plant, who was depending on whom? And who was not depending in this entire scene?
Plant was dependent on all the factors which we spoke about.
Okay. So who were
in? The natural resources are not depending. Natural resources are independent.
Okay. The resources were independent. They were not depending on anyone. Okay. So here we are get. So now tell me what was the key thing that is involved in this entire process? So these are nothing but the observations, okay? There were certain observations involved in it, and each observation has particular characteristics, and then it is going, ultimately giving us the answer. So now let us see, so this helps us to define the concept known as variable. So what is a variable? Can you tell me what is a variable? Now in the growth of plant, what is a variable?
The height of the plant, size of the leaves.
Growth, size of the leaves, okay.
That's height, structure, size, quality.
Yes, yes. So all these are the variables, okay. And so how will you define
it? Because it will vary, ma'am. It will not be uniform.
It is not a constant, okay?
Correct.
It is not a constant.
We think that changes.
Okay, it is constantly changing, it is constantly moving, but it is not stagnant. It has not stopped. Okay, so that is the simple concept. What is a variable? It is not a constant. And the meaning of variable, it starts from, it is simple, the observations that you are having. So observations leads to certain characteristics. So each observation gives us certain characteristics. If the characteristics are common and seen everywhere, then it is a constant. And if the characteristics are not same, okay, not in the same way they are being noted down also, they are known as the variables. Okay, so this is as simple as what is a variable. Each variable is a separate and distinct phenomenon, fine? And variables are the conditions or the characteristics that the experimenter manipulates, controls, or observes. Okay, is there any confusion in this? A variable is a separate, distinct phenomena. Plant of a growth of a plant is a separate, distinct phenomena, and it is depending, or these are the conditions or the characteristics that experimenter manipulates, controls, or observes. So an experimenter can definitely manipulate, okay, control and observe the growth of plant. Okay, so these are the conditions. Now, what can be observed? What can be controlled? Can you tell me what can be manipulated and what can be observed in this growth of plant? Please tell me.
Educational boards can be manipulated, ma'am. The soil, water.
Okay, they can be manipulated. Yes, very good. Fertilizer can be manipulated. I may decide that sunlight should not be, there should not be sunlight. I will keep one plant in the sunlight, one plant with the electric bulb. But light is, I am providing the light, but not the same. So I am varying it. I am controlling this, even the light, which is requirement for that. I can control the soil. I am the decider. What should be there? Being an experimenter, I will manipulate all the other things. I will decide ki whether I will have to put a one spoon of fertilizer or two spoons of fertilizer or a certain three spoons. And I will also decide the ratio of fertilizer with the soil. I will decide the quality of the seed. I will decide a good quality seed. I will decide a raw quality, mediocre quality seed. And I will see the growth of plant in both the cases. Everything I am deciding, being an experimenter, I am deciding. Okay, so that is nothing but the variable. The growth of plant is varying, and I am deciding its growth of the growth of plant if I am an experimenter. Okay, in the natural state, the plants are growing. That is not an issue. Okay, it's growing naturally. But to make it best, to make it good, to make it or if I want to see certain phenomena, like we in schools we have that. The photosynthesis activity, and that was the, then they have that potassium to one side, and then they, one clip was to one side the Vaseline is sprayed, and to the, for the another plant the Vaseline is not given or sprayed on the leaf, and both are kept in the sunlight. All those things were there, and then there was a stain of star shape, something. So these are the conditions that I am trying to varying it as per my expectation. So variables are the conditions or the characteristics that the experimenter decides, controls, observes, and ultimately he comes with the conclusion. So is it clear what is the variable? So variable is nothing, it's a separate distinct phenomena, and these are the conditions or the characteristics that the experimenter manipulates, controls, or observes. So variables can be classified, because of that it can be classified as the quantitative variable and the qualitative variable. So variables, when variables are there, we can again decide what type of variable I am seeing. So quantitative variables are the ones that exist along with continuum that runs from low to high. Okay, and ordinal interval scale or the ratio scale variables are the quantitative variables. And also they are the variables sometimes called continuous variables because they have a variety of characteristics. Can you tell me a quantitative variable which is in your, which that you are observing or that might be in your, that you can see or just think that this is a quantitative variable? Which variables are quantitative variables? What do you mean by ordinal, interval, and ratio variables? Anybody has any idea?
Marks of students.
Okay.
What ordinal would be in some kind of order, ma'am? Increasing or decreasing order.
Just tell me what are the quantitative variables. Yeah, order is there. Ordinal may order. Yeah.
Height of students.
Height of people.
Weight.
Correct. Weight. Okay.
Weight. Yeah.
Height, weight.
Age, grade.
IQ.
IQ, achievement level, motivational level of the students, teachers'
attitude,
their happiness, the students' happiness, their well-beingness. All these things are the variables that can be from low to high. Okay, they can be. There is a continuum is there from the lowest level to the highest. Okay, the economy, the income of the families. The educational level of the parents, the socioeconomic status of the students, all these are the nothing but the quantitative variables where you can quantify them. You can And now ordinal interval ratio, these are the based on the scales, the ordinal ordinal scale is there, ordinal data is there, the interval date, interval scale is there, the ratio scale is there, where there is the where you arrange the data in certain order, you you rank them, you from low to high, you may have an interval scale like the marks of the students from 0 to 100, you may have a IQ level of the students from maybe IQ can't be zero, from below 10 to above 140, something like that. Okay, so these are the quantitative variables, and the IQ is a variable, the height of the student is variable, the marks of the, or you may say the social, the income of the families, you may order them in a hierarchy. So these are the quantitative variables. Can you guess what are the qualitative variables?
Perception, happiness.
Okay, perception, happiness, okay.
Satisfaction.
Economic satisfaction.
Experiences.
Experiences, qualitative. It can be
quantified. Job satisfaction.
Job satisfaction.
Job satisfaction. Also quantified. It can be also quantified. See, job satisfaction level is there. No? So, from satisfied to dissatisfied. Gender. Highly satisfied to the most dissatisfied. So the it can be placed in the quantitative order. So qualitative variables, basically they are sometimes referred as categorical variables because they can classify by categories. Like nominal variables such as gender, religion, or eye color, they are the categorical variables. The gender in the sense male and female, okay? The religions, the languages, the eye color of the student, of the people, or what could be
behavior, ma'am?
The professors, okay, the category of the professors, assistants, professors, and all those categories are there. Where you cannot put them on a, you cannot segregate on a, put them on a continuum scale. Okay, they are just head counts. Are you getting it? The your favorite color. They can be, I like particular color, so I will just see in the class, how many students like white color, red color, blue color? So I may have only head counts. I cannot have that this is best, this is, this is, this color is, this the many number of students have decided that white is maximum number, so this is the best. I cannot have that.
Alt A.
Discrimination. I cannot have the discrimination. Jo hai, so hai. Okay, I can't discriminate on that grounds. Got it? So that is the, these are the qualitative variables. Yeah, somebody who said, somebody said something in between, I just overlooked it.
Behavior.
Behavior, no, it can't be qualitative. It can be like, it can be, yes, yeah, behavior, I may have a socially adjusted, non-socially adjusted. So I may divide them in a dichotomy. And I may have a behavior of socially adjusted, and not socially adjusted. So I may, it can be qualitative to some extent. There could be trained, untrained. Okay, so I may have this category.
Yeah, I meant behavior of special needs children, very unique cases.
Yeah. So that can be, it can be, it's a special case where I can put them in a category. I cannot say this is the best and this is not the best. These are the categories. I can create the categories. And in on any point of time, I cannot have any, you know, continuum scale. You may understand what is a continuum scale. That is a spectrum will be seen. It's not a, it's that is there are nothing but the qualitative variables. I hope I'm clear. So yes, these are the variables, a special case of categorical variable where you can see the dichotomy. Now, as far as the religion is concerned, there can't be a dichotomy. I may have a dichotomy like the majority and minority class. Okay, these are the majority religions, minority religions. But I cannot have the number of religions and I can grade them. No, I can't do that. I cannot say these are the languages and I can grade them. So these are the languages, they are as it is. So they become the qualitative variables where you have the categories and you cannot at any point of time, you can discriminate them on that grounds. Deprived students, deprived class. So these are the classes, these are the deprived classes. And these are the students from the can be included or come under the inclusive education. So I may have these other categories. So these are the variables that can be classified on that slot. But the variables can also, there are the types of variables as we are seeing the growth of plant. So there are the types of variables where I had asked you the what is dependent and what is independent. So the independent variables, they are often also called as the explanatory variables or the predictors. And they are nothing but the causes. And the dependent variables, they are sometimes called as the outcome or the criterion variables. Okay. So which is an effect. So as I asked you, what is the independent variable here? You told me the environment, the air, the fertilizer, the sunlight, the space, the pot, the soil, the quality of seed, all those things are the independent variables. And the dependent variables, the growth of plant, the quality of fruits, the number of fruits, all those things, the leaves, all those, these are the, this is the related with the dependent variables. So independent variables is known as the antecedent and these are known as the consequence. An independent variable is the presumed cause of the dependent variable and dependent variable is the presumed effect. Okay. With these types of variables, besides independent and dependent variable, let us see independent variables. These are, as I told
you. Could you just show that slide again for a second? Could you show the previous slide again for a second? The variable, yeah. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Independent variables, they are the experimental, manual, manipulated, treatment and grouping. Okay. It is the factor which is measured, manipulated or selected by the experimenter. Okay. As I told you, I decide ki what should be the environment of that plant which is kept, whether it should be kept in the dark, whether it should be kept in the sunlight, that I'll decide. So that is the variable which is measured, which can be manipulated or selected by the experimenter. Independent variable is the cause. And role or purpose of independent variable is to determine its relationship to an observed phenomenon. Okay, so this is about the independent variable. Now you may have your independent variable with your topic and you can decide, suppose I'm conducting an experimental research. So what I will have to decide what is my independent variable and what is my dependent variable. Okay, we will come to that in depth once the dependent variable is also clear. Dependent variable, it is the factor which is observed and measured. Dependent variable is an outcome or my finding. And the purpose of dependent variable is to determine the effect of the independent variable. That is that factor which appears, disappears, or varies as the experimenter introduces, removes, or varies the dependent variable. So it is just to determine the effect of the independent variable. Usually all the scientists, all the researchers try to see the relationship between the independent and the dependent variable. With the we are in this pandemic period, we are all are seeing how these vaccines and how the experimenter, the researchers are working upon it. We are seeing the variety in that also, the vaccines which are 100% or which the vaccines which are giving 100% result, 90% result, 80%, 79%, all these things are upcoming and we are constantly seeing. So you can see how this entire thing, the dependent and independent variable are working. Which vaccine is useful in this pandemic situation? Which vaccine is giving the best results in this on this COVID-19? All these things we are seeing during this period, and we are best right time is the best time to see how the vaccines are also being manufactured or they are launched, and what are the very how much time they are taking to be to prove that they are the best results, giving the best results, because ultimately they are applying on the human beings. So the risk factor of the life expectancy is also associated with it. So we are taking lots of efforts to before launching that vaccine. So dependent and independent variable, you can think of it. So independent variable affects a change in dependent variable. Karuna ma'am or Archana ma'am, just give me 1 minute, I'll be back.
No worries. No worries. Yes. No worries. Participants, be there. Ma'am is taking just 1 minute.
Thank you so much. We are seeing, so basically independent and dependent variable are the key things and in any research, and independent variable affects the change in the dependent variable. Okay, but besides independent variable, this is just diagrammatically presented. I have taken it from the websites only. The cause independent variable manipulation, the condition, cause and effect. So independent variable affects the dependent variable. Just remember the plant, the growth of a plant is getting affected because of the independent variables. So we were measuring this and we were seeing its effect, and these are the causes. Suppose if I won't give the water, probably it will affect on the growth of plant. If I won't give the manure, it will affect on the growth of plant. So all these things I will manipulate. I will see I will put the give the water alternate day. I will give water daily. I will give the sunlight alternate day or after 1 week or whatever that I manipulate. I will manipulate. Okay. I will see that to that key and the plants will be kept under the observation. So this is a cause. Independent variable is a cause, and this is an effect on the whatever I'm intending to find out. There could be two independent variables and there could be one dependent variable. There could be many independent variables. There could be many dependent variables. So suppose simultaneously, for example, from the education, I may have two treatments to give to see the interest in mathematics or interest in or achievement in mathematics or maybe. So I may employ two teaching methods. One is the constructivist approach, one is the blended learning mode, and I will see how the achievement in mathematics means. I may decide the two groups, of course. To one group, I will give this constructivist approach I will use while teaching mathematics. Well, to another group, I will use the blended learning approach while teaching mathematics, and I will see how the interest in mathematics is for both the groups. Is it because of this treatment? Okay, so that may happen. Now here they have seen the fixation, the effect of personal health goals on visual attention of different food groups, and they are varying all these whatever they want to check about the dependent variable. They want to see the fixation count and all those things. So these are the various ways with the combinations of independent and dependent variable one can conduct a proper research. But besides that independent variable, there are also various variables which make difference in the, or which may affect or change or bring change in the dependent variable. They are the moderator variables, confounding variables, intervening variables, and extraneous variables. The moderator variables, anybody would like to ask any questions pertaining to the independent and dependent variable only? Or should I proceed? Okay, so let us see one by one, and you may ask questions because some of you might be.
Ma'am, what is the difference between the moderator variable and the extraneous?
I am coming to that. Yeah, I am coming to that. I will explain one by one the moderator. All these variables I'll explain, because those who are conducting the experimental research or the researchers based on the relationships, For them, it is very important to know all these things. And because while giving the justification, you will have to take into consideration all these other variables also besides independent and dependent variable. The two key things remain with your work, that is independent and dependent variable. But those who are conducting the experimental research especially, they cannot ignore the other variables which might become the cause of their findings, okay, or affect on their dependent variable. So let us see moderator variable, also known as the controlled variables. The purpose or the role of moderator variable is to discover whether it modifies the relationship of the independent variable to an observed phenomenon. Okay, now controlled variable, for example, the growth of a plant is very obvious phenomena, okay, in the proper condition. But main who researcher, mujhe bahut find out karna hai, so what I will try to do, I will control the variables also. एक जो plant है वो natural state में grow हो रहा है और एक जो plant है वो मुझे अपने हिसाब से grow करना है. So I will control these variables. So I will control, as I discussed earlier also, I will try to control these factors. उसका sunlight, उसका पानी, उसको कितना पानी देना है, उसको कितना फर्टिलाइजर डालना है, कितने दिन के बाद डालना है, ये सब मैं डिसाइड करने वाली हूँ. सो दैट बिकम्स अ कंट्रोल्ड वेरिएबल. सो दैट इज अ मॉडरेटर वेरिएबल बिकॉज आई नो बिसाइड्स ग्रोथ ऑफ प्लांट, दीज आर द फैक्टर्स विच आई कैन मॉडरेट, आई कैन मैनिपुलेट. दे आर ऑल्सो अ इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल ऑल्सो, दे आर सो इट इज अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल विच कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड. द इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स रिलेशनशिप with the dependent variable may change under the different conditions. So that condition is the moderator variable. Suppose, as I told you earlier also, now suppose this is one study of two methods, teaching reading. One of the methods of teaching reading may work better with boys and then girls. So method of teaching reading is the independent variable and reading achievement is the dependent variable. Now gender is the moderator variable because it moderates or changes the relationship between the independent variable. That is a teaching method and the dependent variable, that is reading achievement. The girls and the boys is my moderate variable. I am going to control it. Okay. I will see to that because of is the gender is making difference or my findings will be very much associated with the gender also. So I will observe that. Okay. I may control that variable if I'm observing I can control that variable also. I will decide that, okay, I will only employ on the boys. I only employ on this teaching method of reading only on girls. And then I will see. So I can control this particular variable. And that is why it becomes a moderate variable. So this is the what I wanted to say. Now, for example, this is my study. Does red light affect the plant growth? So independent variable is light color. That is color of the light. That is yellow and red. Then dependent variable is the plant height and control variables will be then the water, the soil, the temperature and day and night. So these are my moderate variables. Okay. So what I am going to intend to do, that becomes my independent and dependent variable. And also I want to control, they are independent variables, but I'm going to put some check over it. I'm going to keep some eye over it. I'm going to observe their quantity, their quality, their temperature level, the day and night, everything I'm going to. So they become the moderate variable. Okay. I hope I am clear with moderate variable. I can take
ma'am, that means, ma'am, that means we need to situate that the control variables are more or less the same for both the groups which are under study.
Yeah. So I can control the variables. For example, I'm conducting the, obviously the example comes in my mind that is about the experimental research. As I told you,
particular example, like I will try to maintain the amount of water, the soil, everything will be uniform for both the set of plants.
No. I will control the, I just, since I want to see only the effect of light, red light or yellow light, since I am focusing only on that, so I will control the other variables like water, soil, temperature and all those things. I will give the, for example, I will tell you the example from the education. Now there are two groups, experimental group and the control group. Okay, the group which is not getting the treatment that you, I'm going to give.
Yes.
For example, traditional mode, usually we compare, I mean, so many years, the teachers are comparing the difference between the traditional way of teaching and some novel or innovative method of teaching. So this one innovative method and the traditional method. So when I agree to the fact that there are individual differences, still I will see to that both the students of both the groups, that is experimental group and the control group, I will they should be more or less same. How they will be more or less? So I will control the variables like there is both the groups should have. Maybe I will decide they belong to the same school or same type of school, maybe aided or unaided. If they are both of them are from aided school, I will see to that their socioeconomic status is also more or less same, or their achievement level is also more or less. Okay, I will see to that both the students from both the group are from the same locality. एक अगर मुझे ट्रीटमेंट देना है मुझे एक इनोवेटिव मेथड जो मैंने इंटेंड किए तो मैं एक यहाँ पे नवी मुंबई में ट्राई करूँ और एक मैं ठाणे एरिया में ट्राई करूँ नो ऐसे नहीं चले आई विल कंट्रोल दिस वेरिएबल्स आई विल सी दैट बोथ द ग्रुप्स बोथ द स्कूल शुड बिलोंग टू द सेम लोकेलिटी सो इन दिस वे आई विल ट्राई टू कवर कंट्रोल द वेरिएबल्स बिकॉज I may have as one group from South Bombay, one group from the urban area, suburbs may. So definitely I will see that the findings will make a difference. Okay, because of the locality, because of the socioeconomic status, because of the parental background sometimes, because of the achievement level, it may make a difference. I may have both the schools may be in the same area, but both the schools have the achievement level, the students' achievement level is already differing. Then again, I will see that it making a difference on my findings. Independent variable is the making difference on the findings. Are you getting it? So that is why they are controlled variables or the model variables. Now there are certain variables known as the confounding variables. That means they may confuse you. Okay. So these are the variables closely related to both the independent and the dependent variables in the study. An independent variable represents a supposed cause, while the dependent variable is the supposed. So confounding variable is a third variable that influences both. Now this variable is a variable which influences both independent and dependent variable. So you while reporting, you may get confused ki iski wajah se ho gaya ki iski wajah se ho gaya. Kisne kis pe effect kiya, independent variable pe effect kiya ki dependent variable pe effect. So independent variable affects the relationship between both, that is the simultaneously is affecting on both independent as well as the dependent variable. Okay. Any example?
Can we see the confounding variable slide again?
The example could be these are the variables which may confuse you while reporting, just a minute, let me recall the example.
Can personality be a confounding variable?
The individual differences, yes, it could be the behavior of the teachers. Okay, so that is, you may control the, again, the schools. You may control the schools from both the areas, you may control lots of factors, but there are certain factors which may not be in your picture, which may not be seen over there, but they are towards the back of the research, they are functioning very hard.
Ma'am, can learning style be a confounding variable? Learning style of the students.
Maybe confounding variable, maybe the timing of the examination. You don't know, that could be the confounding variable. You might be deciding that, suppose you are conducting an achievement test before the lunch break and for one group. and you are conducting the achievement test after the lunch to another group. So that, and you might have not noticed it, but that is affecting on both independent as well as dependent variable. Okay, and your findings will occur. Are you getting it? So yeah, behavior of the student, the individual differences. Yes, that means some, there are certain students who, okay, so for example, you may ask the students कि आपके ऊपर एक्सपेरिमेंट करने वाले हैं और आपके रिजल्ट्स जांचे जाएंगे, तो स्टूडेंट्स गेट मोटिवेटेड और डीमोटिवेटेड. ओके, सो दैट कुड, दैट मे मेक अ डिफरेंस ऑन योर ट्रीटमेंट एंड योर फाइंडिंग्स. ओके, द स्टूडेंट हाईली मोटिवेटेड स्टूडेंट्स, तो अगर आपने ये जो फैक्टर इंट्रोड्यूस किया कंपाउंड मेरियल की, आप ऑब्जर्व करने कि यू विल बी इवेल्युएटेड आफ्टर दिस, देन द स्टूडेंट्स मे टेक इट पॉजिटिवली और निगेटिव. सो यू डोंट नो ये अचानक से स्टूडेंट्स जो लो थे अचानक कैसे हाई परफॉर्म किया, और अच्छे वाले स्टूडेंट्स से अचानक लो कैसे परफॉर्म किया. सो दे आर द कंफाउंडिंग वेरिएबल्स. आई होप आई एम क्लियर विद दिस. सो दिस अफेक्ट बोथ इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, अफेक्ट्स द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन बोथ इंडिपेंडेंट एंड द डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. द इंटरवेनिंग वेरिएबल इज अ वेरिएबल दैट अफेक्ट्स द रिलेशनशिप अगेन बोथ. Often this type of variable can appear when the researchers are studying the relationship between the two variables and don't realize the another, that another variable is actually intervening variable in the relationship. Intervening variables pop up in many different research situations. Yes, as I told you, so this may cause again affect or make a difference in the relationship between the both. For example, level of education is my independent variable and spending on the education is my dependent variable, but the intervening variable is the income. Okay, so it may make a difference on my dependent variable. My spending on education may make a difference on my income. These are just examples, you may add into it. The independent variable is a poverty and the dependent variable is a life expectancy. The worse health care, so this is an intervening variable. Are you getting it or no? So this
socioeconomic status can be an intervening variable.
Yes, can be intervening variable, which can be controlled also to some extent. So it is affecting the socioeconomic status on independent variable. So the poverty, the level of education of the parents, these are the cultural background of the students. These are all affecting on the students' achievements. Yes, so they are the intervening variables which are underlying, which are not visible vividly, but they are there and they are making a difference. The hours spent practicing is an independent variable. The points per game is a dependent variable. But the minutes played, how much practice I am doing, how many minutes I am playing, is my intervening variable. I may be spending 1 hour, 1-2 hours. So these I'm observing, but the minutes played also can become the intervening variable. Now, for example, here the best example that we understand, that is independent variable is a teacher and a dependent variable are the students, but the intervening variable here is a curriculum. What kind of curriculum is there, which is making a difference on the students' achievement? The curriculum, that is why the boards, now we are comparing the boards because the curriculum of each board is different. Are you getting it? So this becomes an intervening variable. The teachers are there, the students are there, but the curriculum, what kind of curriculum that you are providing to the students becomes an intervening variable.
So, ma'am, if I take care of the confounding variables, that means the number of intervening variables can be reduced?
Sorry?
If I take care about the control or the confounding variables,
yes,
that means the intervening variables can be reduced?
No. See, all these they are the intervening. I didn't get it. Can you give me an example? I can try to understand.
Like we just discussed traditional teaching method with the innovative method of teaching. So in that, you gave an example of like how I give the exam at two different timings for the control group and the experimental group.
Yeah.
So if I take it to see that this
is not done. When you are conducting the experimental, you try to see the ideal situations. I mean, for both the groups. Okay, you will try to bring what, because it's not a scientific research like itna solution add kiya to yahi result milega karke. When you are dealing with the social science researches, these are the factors already working. Okay, already the environment of the students, already the psychological factor of the students, the soft factors which you cannot see them, but they are already existing. Yes. That might make a difference. Okay, the students, the timing of the even conducting the test, okay, that also matters a lot. Okay, when you are conducting the treatment, what time you are giving the treatment. See, in one school you go and give the treatment in the morning slot, in one school you go and give the treatment in the evening slot or after the lunch break. It may make a difference. Yeah, the timing of the schools. एक है जो मॉर्निंग शिफ्ट में है, एक है जो इवनिंग शिफ्ट में है, एंड यू आर गिविंग द ट्रीटमेंट इन द फर्स्ट पीरियड, दैट आल्सो कैन मेक अ डिफरेंस. सो यू ट्राई टू सी हाउ कैन यू ब्रिंग द कंट्रोल ऑन ऑल दीज फैक्टर्स, एंड दैट इज व्हाई दे
कैन द प्री टेस्ट पोस्ट बी कंट्रोल्ड.
यस दैट इज द रीजन प्री टेस्ट पोस्ट टेस्ट टू बी कंट्रोल्ड. बोथ द टेस्ट शुड बी कंडक्टेड एट द राइट एट द आइडियल टाइम. आई मीन बोथ द students should have the pre-test timings more or less same, without much gap of even the days. Agar ek, hardly you can have the maximum 15 days gap between the for the both the groups. Pre-test agar ek group ko aaj ki tarikh mein maine kiya hai, to 15 din maximum mein ka timing leke main dusre group pe test conduct karungi. Main ek mahine ya do mahine ke baad pre test conduct karungi, to the results I will not get as per my expectation. So that is to be controlled. So these are the intervening variables, and there are extraneous variables and these factors which cannot be controlled, which is not beyond researchers' control. So these factors are independent variables that have not been controlled. They may or may not influence influence the result or may not influence the results. An extraneous variable, any variable you are not interested in studying, that could not also say have some effect on the dependent variable. Means you are not interested, but they are working. There is a list of extraneous variable and which can be seen. The independent variables here. We want to know the independent variable affects the dependent variable in some way. The extraneous variable, unfortunately, extraneous variables that we are not interested in might be also the dependent variable. For example, the hours spent, we want to know if hours spent in training affects the average point per game. This is average points of game. But the hours spent, that is hours spent stretching, may also affect the average points per game. So these are the things which we have overlooked, which might not be in our thought also, but they may make a difference. The independent variables, like we are the sequential methods of teaching, and these are the models, and extraneous variables is the age of learners, gender of learners, teachers' qualifications, and in-service training of teachers. And your dependent variable is achievement in biology, retention of biology, score on retention test, transfer of biology knowledge, score on concept maps. So these are the factors. These are the extraneous variables which may make a difference and which cannot be in your what you say.
And these cannot be changed, basically.
Yes, this cannot be changed. Okay, that in teacher qualifications, you cannot change a teacher qualification. Okay, you cannot change. एक स्कूल में मैं जाके पढ़ा रही हूँ, एक स्कूल में दूसरी कोई टीचर है जो अपने हिसाब से पढ़ा रही है, तो वो क्वालिफिकेशन यू माइट बी सेम इन द क्वालिफिकेशन, बट सो विच यू कैन विच इज बट योर वे ऑफ गिविंग ट्रीटमेंट माइट बी डिफरेंट दैन द अदर टीचर, सो दैट क्वालिफिकेशन दैट कैनॉट बी कंट्रोल. सो दीज आर द एक्सट्रेनियस वेरिएबल्स. So in the experimental research, research variable based on type of training, in experimental research, independent variable comes first and influences or predicts, which can be manipulated and anticipated, which is a cause. and a dependent variable comes second, okay, if affected or predicted by the independent variable. Obviously, independent variable in the experimental research, independent variable pehle aata hai aur dependent variable baad mein aata hai. These are the extraneous factors which I wanted to tell you. The participants, which is beyond your control, their history, maturation, attribution, depend characteristics, evaluation of apprehension, diffusion of treatment. For example, just to take an example of maturation. As I was telling you, suppose I am conducting the research on 8 standard students. The maturation factor is very much important in this. I am conducting pre-test in the first week, and I am and the students' age level is more or less same. But if I decide to conduct the pre-test with the other group after 2 months, there is a maturation in that group. Okay. And you will find there is a much because of maturity, the students are giving the better answers. Their exposure might be there during that time to the various other factors. There could be the history factor, which is between the two pre-tests, there could be with the same group pre and post-test, the history, or there could be a major event which have taken place and the students become all of a sudden matured because of that particular incidences. Maybe which is common to all, maybe the, what you can say, the earthquake is there, maybe some bomb explosion there. We don't know what could be the consequences, and the crisis could be there. And such type of incidences may make a difference on their maturity level, may make a difference on their when they are appearing for the for particular achievement test. Or so the incidences like abhi jo chal raha hai already COVID ki wajah se, these are the things they are definitely making difference on the participants, and that can become the extraneous variable, which is not, you cannot control all these things. Aapke bas ki baat hi nahi hai ye jo cheeze, lekin ye jo cheeze hai wo definitely can may make or may not make. Okay, it may make or may not make. Yeah, please make understand. Agar difference karti hai to you cannot relate directly to this particular factor, but you may relate to that factor also. So history as then experimenter characteristics, as I told you, the teachers, who is conducting the experiment. Aap jaake dono school mein jaake padha rahe to that factor you can control. कि आपने इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल जो आपकी ट्रीटमेंट है वो जो इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल है आपने दोनों स्कूल में जाके पढ़ा, ट्रेडिशनली भी पढ़ाया और इनोवेटिवली भी पढ़ाया, तो ये फैक्टर आपने कंट्रोल किया. लेकिन जो ये फैक्टर जो है वो अगर आपके हाथ में नहीं है, जो दूसरे स्कूल में जो टीचर है वो पढ़ा रही है और उसके जो रिजल्ट है और आपके रिजल्ट से, ये आपके ये जो एक्सटर्नियस फैक्टर है वो आप नहीं कंट्रोल कर सकते और वो आपको मानना ही पड़ेगा. Okay, then experimental bias. It is possible that experimental theoretical bias led to the unintentional recording. Yeah, recordings also errors. That is also there. How the what lens you are? You may be feminist, you may be positivist, you may be constructivist approach. You may have a different lenses. You may have a baggage of so many things with you. You may look towards the particular students in a particular way. So that baggage may also, that experimental bias may affect even on your treatment, and that may affect on your dependent variable. So these are the things, the methods, what kind of for example, you may conduct the experimental method, you may conduct the traditional method to know the same variable. Suppose I may want to study students' achievement without any, just as a survey, and I want to study the achievement with the experiment. So the factor may be same, but the method may be different. So that may make a difference. The tasks, the instructions, the testing. As I told you, the testing. Ek subah liya, ek sham ko liya, ek group ke saath subah liya, ek group ke saath sham ko liya. So these are the factors which may make a difference on the findings. The instrumentation, the regression in the of the mean, all those things. These are the so many extraneous variables which are there when you conduct the experimental study. So when you are conducting the social science researches, you have to be very careful, and you have to control all these factors, and you have to keep in mind all these things. There are Hawthorne-Whitehead effects, there are the this Hawthorne effect is definitely there, the Henry effect, all these things are there. These may make a difference in your experiment. So you may, these are the examples where the things are discussed. For example, implementation of quality function, if you, I mean, this is one experimental research. So independent variable here is the in-service training to the teachers, and the dependent variable are the teacher's efficacy, students' better cognitive awareness. And the control variables may be the gender of the, years of experience of the teacher, the gender of the students, or the aided, unaided. All this can be controlled by me, or controlled by the researcher, and the treatment can be given. You may share your examples, and you can think of it also. If it is not experimental research, if it is just one causal comparative research, a survey type of research, or a historical research, or a correlation or qualitative type of research, independent variable cannot be manipulated. Okay, you just go on collecting the way you want. And you can just go on reporting the relationship between the two variables. The IQ of the students, the gender of the students, the commitment of the teachers, the well-being awareness of the teachers, the online teaching, these are all the variables which are not, you are not controlling. You are accepting them as it is, but you want to see the relationship, probably the online, the attitude, can you give me an example? Maybe the organizational behavior of the teachers and the experience of the teachers. I would like to see the relationship. Who are more committed, the commitment of the teachers and their gender, the commitment of the teachers with their the type of school, with their salary, with their job satisfaction level, and the commitment. I would like to see your organizational justice with the culture of the school. All those things, these are the independent and the dependent variable. And you don't know who is dependent in such researches. Also, you don't know who is dependent on whom. Okay. You don't know who is dependent on you. In case of citizenship behavior of the teachers, the organizational behavior of the teachers may be the dependent variable, independent variable, and the dependent variables are something. So I may interchange also what I would like to say. So in the correlational studies, antecedents called predictive variable, the dependent variable called the criterion variable, and not always possible to tell which comes first. As I told you, you don't know what comes first. So when prediction, not goal, but rather to see if there is a relationship between the variable. So we very diplomatically use that. We ascertain the relationship between the two. Okay, we see to that. But it's not that any two variables you bring and try to ascertain the relationship. For example, the skin of my color and my IQ level has no relationship. Even if I do any extensive review of related literature, I will not find any theoretical background between for that key, which is supporting the skin of the color and the IQ of a person. So that is why it is need to do the review of related literature, because sometimes the students have a habit of choosing any two variables and they see to that there is there any relationship between them. I will never get in the relationship between the length of my hair and the IQ of my or height of my of an individual. Okay, there is no relationship between the two things. Okay, so that is the reason you have to extensively do the find out any theory supporting to my findings. Any theory will support to my findings or not. Okay, so the variables, when you choose even the variables or the research topics for your study, which variables that you are selecting, and does it have any theoretical framework or any theory supporting to that? So choose such variables. I remember I went for one for evaluating one research. Of course, it was at a very master's at the beginner's level, so it's not a cause, it's not a big deal. But the two variables, the two variables which I have, so when I read the title, when I read the topic, I knew that there can't be relationship between the two things. There can't be relation between two variables, and exactly the findings that I found. When you read the topic itself, you come to know there can't be any relationship between these two variables. Then such a research is the best. I know that when there can't be any relationship between the two, even if I conduct properly with proper scientific method, I know what would be the results. And I, as I expected, when I read the topic, I know there can't be relationship. And the same results, there was no relationship between these two groups. I don't remember. It was really based on some management only. And I don't know, maybe later on, later stage, I maybe remember. But that is why review of literature is very, very important step before finalizing your research topic, before finalizing your variables. Because you may have some hypothetical ideas and everything, but your research may go, should not go a waste despite of spending 2-3 years, and you will realize that, oh, it's a waste that I don't find as what I was expecting. So when it's not that ki, agar relationship mili, nahi mili, to aapka research waste ho gaya. You may support, you may give the justification. For example, I was conducting the one innovative method, and the variable, dependent variable was the interest of the students in mathematics and achievement in mathematics. I got the positive results for the achievement in mathematics, but I definitely didn't get the positive results in the interest in mathematics. The justification for that, I gave the justification for that, because interest is such a psychological variable to bring to interest in one particular subject. I need to spend more than 2-3 years for that. So then only I can get the positive results. Just in within 2-3 months, I conduct the statement, I conduct a treatment, and all of a sudden I get a miracle. So students are interested in this particular subject. And if you are giving such results, probably you will miss, you are misguiding. Okay, you will not get such a results also. So even if you don't get such results, don't manipulate it. But give the supporting, and that is why again the variable review of related literature is very much important. So I can support with the evidences that, okay, such type of research was conducted with such students, and definitely the interest was not generated. Okay, then your objectives are, and your findings are matching with someone else's objectives. So that becomes a one research supporting to your objectives or your findings will definitely make a difference. So these are the some key things you have to keep in mind while doing the review of related literature, as well as choosing the variables of the study. With this, I can, these are some examples where you can, these are the based on the only how the relationship can be find out. The study of secondary school students' emotional intelligence in relation to their academic achievement, or a study of habits of secondary school students in relation to their classroom climate. Then a study students Sanskrit study of students maybe attitude, Sanskrit teachers attitude, students teachers Sanskrit teaching attitude, and so teachers attitude on the basis of different levels of education. A comparative study of value orientation of secondary school students on the basis of different types of students. Now this is not a relational study. This is just a survey type of research. Then a study of racial citizenship behavior of secondary school teachers on the basis of their research characteristics. So such type of studies can be conducted. Now this is a model where you can see the very many variables are taken into consideration, and then that can be, you can see the student achievement is a dependent variable, but you don't know what is the what are the various independent variables that are working. There are certain external, I just wanted to give one exercise based on this. Just identify what is the independent and dependent variables and the moderate and the extraneous and compounding variables in this. So this was just wanted to give an exercise, but let it be, now it's already 1:30, and with the permission of organization, I am actually through with what I intended to teach. Can I stop my presentation?
Yes, ma'am.
And I can take the questions from the audiences, and you may ask the questions also. So that's all.
Usha ma'am?
Yeah. Once again, good afternoon, Ashwini ma'am. So yes. Most of the questions you have answered. There are a couple of questions which are there in the chat box, post for you, ma'am.
I can see. Do intervening and interviewing intermingle sometimes? Yes, yeah, they are overlapping actually. Even independent, dependent variable, though we name them as intervening or compounding, some of them are the independent variables, but they are not the actual what you can say, or they are the focus of your research for. Okay, you have decided certain variables as your research topic, but there are certain variables which are also working as an independent variable, and they may overlap. Yes, they may overlap. In non-experimental, is it okay if we have only two variables, one independent? It's okay. Yeah. It's okay. Even in the experimental research also, you may have only one and independent dependent variable. In the experimental research also, you may have a 2-3 independent variables and one dependent variable. If you are conducting the research projects on large scale, you may have a 2 dependent variables and 1-3 independent variables also. All possible combinations can be done, and only thing, it will be when you are doing its analysis, you have to be very careful. Nowadays there are software, so all they are taking care of all these things also. So no issue, no problem. You may go with the very great ambitious ideas, but you, while doing analysis, it should not go beyond your control. So that may cause a that may make a difference. Shall I stop my sharing screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Do we mention confounding or intermingling in our research? Yes, you have to mention the controlled variables at least. Okay, you have to mention that. Yes, Madhavi, you have any doubt? Yeah, Madhavi is our department student also. She has done PGTM.
Yes, ma'am.
I think last time when I visited to HJ, she was there. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Please. Do we have
any other question, or should we move ahead?
Participants, if you have any questions which you would like to pose to Ashwini ma'am, you can unmute yourself and you can ask your questions to Ashwini ma'am.
Yeah, directly also you may ask me question, or just unmute yourself and you can ask. I think no questions.
This is related to the earlier related review that we were discussing. Ma'am, I would also like to know that if suppose I have taken reference from X person, okay, and that X person's bibliography is also bibliography reference of Y is also connected to my study, so that can be taken as related literature.
No, didn't get. So you are referring someone else's thesis, and you got the reference.
I am referring somebody else's thesis. I got the reference. That particular thesis is my related review literature, right?
Yes.
But when I go to that bibliography and that study also is connected to my study, like I draw some inferences from there also. So is that also connect? Will come under my review literature?
No, that can't be. But what I understand is that, are you talking about the reviews of related literature and then its references? So for example, my student has done 1, 2, 3, 4 review of related literature. And yeah. I can see that student has, I can write that I have cited in her reference in this particular thesis. But I don't think so. That is the direct way that you can include in your video. That's why.
Okay.
I am not clear what exactly you want to say.
I am talking about, suppose I am referring, in my review of related literature, I am referring to some Mr. X, his thesis. Okay. If that becomes my review literature, I can mention that as my review of related. From his thesis, if in the
you cannot refer her bibliography. You may go and find it out. The bibliography is given for you to find out.
Exactly. If the link is given there and I refer from that,
then you
from that link.
Then you go to that link and check it. And then you can put in your list. But that bibliography that can become to some extent as a reference, but you will have to mention cited in so and so. And if you are actually going and doing, referring to that website or finding out that resource, then that can be included, but not in that way that you want to.
I got it. Yeah, it's clear now. Thank you so much, ma'am.
So participants, are there any more questions?
I had a question. May I?
Yeah, ma'am.
Regarding these all these type of variables that you just discussed, the confounding, intervening, and all extraneous and all that. So when I take up an area of research, there are bound to be a number of confounding variables, a number of intervening variables.
Yes.
So do I define all the confounding variables, or do I limit my study to only certain confounding variables? And what about the intervening and the extraneous variables? Do I just mention about what are the possible intervening?
Are you conducting experimental research?
Yes, ma'am.
If you're conducting
the experimental research, module, yeah.
Then you have to mention what are your confounding variables and how you have controlled them. You need to mention that.
So all the possible control variables.
Because you will not get very identical sample in this case, experimental
research. Yes, yes.
Then it will affect on your files. So you have to control them. We are not here doing the lab research. The lab research things can be controlled in a very nice manner. But in the social science research, yes, you need to have the... you have to control in a different way, and it is beyond your limitations, but try to do it in
the maximum possible extent
and give the justice to your experiment.
Okay, and about the other variables, I just mentioned which are the variables and in what way they would have affected my result.
Yeah.
The intervening, the extraneous and all that.
Yeah. You have to mention, and you have to limit also which variables you will be controlling after discussing with your guide, and also see the review of related literature. This researcher has done such type of experiment. What things that this researcher has controlled in his capacity? That you just see. That is the reason you have to do review of related literature. कि दूसरों ने क्या क्या उससे मैं क्या lesson ले सकती हूँ? कि कुछ चीजें जो कर सकती थी, जो can I control these research things in my research and then conduct in a different way?
Okay.
So thank you, ma'am.
Ashwini ma'am, there are lots and lots of messages for you in the chat box. Participants have appreciated your session and the information that you have shared, and they have expressed gratitude to you. I guess there are no more questions. Karuna ma'am, are there any questions in the WhatsApp group?
No, Shama. No, on the WhatsApp.
All right. So, Ashwini ma'am, with that, I'm going to be, of course, there is a gratitude expressed by the participants, but there is something more. I shall request Karuna ma'am to take over.
Thank you, Usha ma'am. Thank you, Dr. Ashwini. We have come to an end to the fourth day, and I'm sure that we had a wonderful session with you, ma'am. Also, something very important which is relevant to research. We start with the review, and I'm sure how important review is, and that gives us a direction. Basically, that gives direction to every researcher how to move ahead in the research. And then variables. I'm sure that the kind of information which you provided for both the topics was very, 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 clear. Participants will definitely use that information in their research in order to, make their research very effective, clear, lucid, specific. I'm sure that you gave them lots of information how to move ahead with their research in a very, very, very clear manner. Thank you so much for a very enriching, very clear, very lucid and specific session, ma'am. And lots of takeaways from your session, but we need to have a formal vote of thanks, ma'am. So I request our research scholar, Madhavi, Ms. Madhavi Wagle, to propose the formal vote of thanks to Ashwini, ma'am. Over to you, Madhavi.
Thank you,
Over to you, Madhavi. Madhavi, I need to tell you one thing, that your smile is always very special. Huh? That brightens up the environment, and today itself it has done that.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It's all because of the wonderful session that we had and the involvement of the entire agency team. So let me begin with the vote of thanks that have been a very warm good afternoon to everyone. On behalf of the parent body of Hansraj Givindas College of Education, Gujarat Research Society, Principal Madam Dr. Anita Swami, the entire HJCE team, and all the co-participants of the capacity building program and the pre-PhD course organized by the HJCE Center of Innovation under the aegis of RUSA, I, Madhavi Bagre, a research scholar, Dr. Usha Borkar, have got this full opportunity to convey our heartfelt gratitude to our learned research scholar, resource person, Ashwini Karwande. Ashwini ma'am, as Karuna ma'am introduced at the start of the session today, has a vast experience in the field of research. Her expertise in guiding students as well as her personal achievements made today's session really interesting and enriching. As she aptly mentioned, review of related literature is a major component of research. She explained the purpose of review of related literature and how it helps the new researchers zero down on the topic of their interest and to the current research scholars to gain an in-depth in the knowledge of their research. Ma'am also gave us an insight on the different sources of information and how to look at the different researchers and how we can infer from them using a synthesis matrix. Madam, you very beautifully introduced the concept of variables using the simple example of the growth of a plant. Qualitative and quantitative variables along with the types of variables was also discussed in detail. Now, as ma'am mentioned, I have been blessed to be Ashwini ma'am's student for PGDME. To share a little bit about madam is a very, very open person who shares her experience with anybody and everybody who goes to her, who approaches her. She never holds anything back. Even now, after so many years after completing my course, I can pick up my phone, call her and ask her for advice. And she'll be the first person to tell me what to do and how to go ahead with it. So ma'am, I'm really blessed to have you as one of my teachers. You really make an impact in all your students' life. Just a little bit more on that. Co-participants, I'm sure that all of you all will agree that ma'am's session today was very lucid and fluid, and she has touched the curious nerve in all of us today. And now we would embark on our journey of research with a better understanding of how the review of related literature has to be done and how the variables work and how we have to be in control of them and make sure that, you know, our research proceeds in the correct direction. So Ashwini ma'am, once again, on behalf of the entire team of HJCE and all us co-participants, would like to thank you from the bottom of my heart for explaining all the concepts in details and answering all the queries from time to time as and when we wanted to know more. Thank you so much, ma'am. We really appreciate that you gave so much time to us from your busy schedule, and we really loved the way everything was explained. Thank you once again.
So much flowering and so much showers of blessing and all those things.
Thank you.
Ashwini ma'am, I agree with Madhavi. I agree. Though I had been your student for a very short time, just last five, six months.
Batch when I joined the department in 2005.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
Your batch was very, I still remember each and every student is still. I admired their work also, and they remember me, and I also remember them because it was my first experience in the department. So their batches was a lovely batch. Aradhana and all these are from their batches.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. And thank you so much. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you all of you once again for giving me this opportunity. And
thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Karuna, thank you. Usha is my classmate, batchmate.
Yes. Thank you so much, ma'am. Usha ma'am, Archana ma'am, should we then wind up for the day?
Yes.
All right. Participants, till we meet tomorrow, do take care of yourself and stay safe, stay healthy. And yes, feedback link will be sent in the group immediately after the session. And see you all tomorrow. Do take good care of yourself.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.